You guys? There's a shark inside of our sea snake exhibit. Hey, nope, nope. Get back, buddy. Get back. I don't need any of your nonsense. I'm gonna smack that tail. Yeah, yeah. What is it? So there's some sharks and fish inside of our exhibit. I can't believe this. This is kind of hilarious. You don't belong in there, sir. This exhibit is for sea snakes. How to take care of our interloper. So apparently they can spawn in. That'll make making a aquarium either trickier or easier, depending on how things go. Hey, Mr. Shark. Hey, Mr. Shark. Dang it, Mr. Shark, you made me get out of here. No, don't eat me. Get out of here. This is my sea snake exhibit. Jeez. Look at that guy. He made me accidentally pull up some of our coral. Dang it, that was hard to place. Especially that one. But as you can see, everybody, I'm sorry I didn't keep you around for the coral placing. It was my reward for dealing with the chaos that is trying to make still water. Normally, I like to keep you guys with me because, you know, you're my buddies when we're busy building everything. But holy moly, I learned pretty quickly. Let's put this. Get down. There. That making still water was a little more complicated than I thought it would be. It's not just a matter of getting the water to flow. There's all sorts of other things involved. But the end result, we're going to dive down just to, the end result is this lovely, lovely sight. I mean, look at how pretty all of that is. This is going to be where our sea snake is going to come in. And apparently he already has some buddies. Hi, Mr. Salmon. Pretty sure you're a salmon. We'll work on our fish ID 101 in a little bit. All right. So yes, let me jump down. Just want to take it all in now that it's shark free. At least we got some shark teeth. Normally we have to travel all the way over there, haul bunny hunkers to the end of the earth just so that we can find the sharks. That's definitely interesting. But yes, here we go. Gotta put that coral. I gotta scooch that coral over one. It's uneven. Look at this. Oh, and look at this. Isn't this just awesome? Look at all the hard work we put into this. I mean, just take a moment and let it sink in how much work we put into doing this. We hunted for the coral reef biome. Well, first off, I mean, we had to gather the limestone itself, which takes a little while because it spawns in pockets, like kind of randomly too. You have to kind of walk a while to find it, dig around. So we put the limestone up, had to get the sand from a faraway desert. We tried to find the coral, traveled, got lost, ended up finding the Village of Light because, and the Dead Village, Nightshade Village, because of these coral hunting things. And that didn't work, so then we had to build the Marine Research Lab, hire an employee, and then have him sell us coral. There has been a huge arc of work going into just this single exhibit. That's how much detail and depth we're trying to put into all of this. Aw, man. So it's just great. And yes, it is still water everywhere. It took a long time for me to figure out how to do that, but thankfully we've got it worked out now. There's a little path right here so things can continue to swim. I just want to get down here because it's just a little bit. Okay, come here. You, I'm going to scoot you over right there. There, that's balanced, more balanced. And yes, the coral, I mean, the coral just looks beautiful. I love that. This is going to be a really stunning exhibit, and I've decided that we're going to have a sea crate, which is one of the, I hear that they're one of the more fussy pants sea snakes, but we're going to put a sea crate right here, and hopefully we'll have just enough glass to finish this up, and then we'll add in a few fish, some tamed fish, to be his buddies. But let's go ahead and get our little sea crate. Which is a type of sea snake in here. We do have enough glass. It's a miracle. There we go. And we'll just build our way out with some. Well, I thought I had dirt. I guess we'll build our way out with limestone. There we go. All right. Oh, this is exciting. Okay. I got the egg. Have the egg. Finally. So much work just for this one egg. There. There you go, little baby. Okay, and I brought some shrubs and things that we can kind of sprinkle around. Or not, apparently. Dang it! Oh well. I was going to put down, like, all these little desert flowers and shrubs, but I forgot that we actually have. Let's see, let's put that over there. Where'd it go? Ah, dang it! I hate it when you pick it up by accident. Okay, there. All right, so I guess that's all we can decorate. I was gonna decorate your area a lot more, little one, but I can't put too many things down because it has to be on sand, and I had to use sandstone right here. So I'm sorry, it doesn't have as many grasses. Dang it! Come on, hatch already. All right, I'm staying over here. Don't worry, I'm right here. We're gonna name you Sea Crate. Oh, I'm so excited. And we'll go get some fish. And finally, we have this exhibit finished. It was quite the monumental effort and achievement that went into this one place. I mean, this is episode 49. 49! That's absolutely Nutter Butters. Nutter Butters, Lillian Tate. You almost hatching. Come on out. All right, there we go. There we go. Look at you. Look at you, little one. This is the coral snake, this is the coral snake skin for mo creatures, but we're going to use it for our wee little snake. Hi, little baby. Hi. You're very cute, you know. I hope you enjoy your entire exhibit. I'm not sure if you swim. I hope you do. It is getting dark. I'll be back in a little bit to check on you. We're gonna go get him some fish buddies. Oh, this is so exciting. Okay, and boink. There we go. All right, let's go get fish buddies. Lily, date, you wanna come with? We're gonna go fishing after this. Let's just pop into bed real fast so the night will pass us by. Sans zombies. But yes, the plan is to do something very special for the next episode, since it is going to be episode 50. And I do indeed have a very special item that I'm very excited to have within my possession. So that's what we're going to do next, is see about that. All right, let's go. Hey, come on, Lily Tate. Let's check on everybody. Holy crap, you've gotten so big. Look at you. That is one happy reticulated python, if you ask me. Look at that serpentine movement. Snakes actually move in a whole bunch of different patterns. Like they can do caterpillar sort of moves where they like hunch their butt up towards their chest and then go rah, rah, rah. Or they can do the sneaky moves where they go the serpentine little S shape that most people are familiar with snakes. I believe all of you guys are that motif. Look at that and your little mud spot. Hi, black snake. You're not too black, but we'll forgive that. All right, and then we'll come over here. And we're gonna probably have. He is swimming! Yay! Hopefully, he won't drown, but I don't think he will. So, this should look pretty cool. Look at him go! Oh, awesome little guy. I'm so proud of him. And how are our rattlesnakes today? Look at how big you guys have gotten. Man, everybody's doing so great. Let's go put the rest of these desert flowers in there. Lily Tate, actually, I should make you guys sit. You guys can't come with me into the rattlesnake exhibit. Not allowed. Hi, guys! Yep, just me. No need for the stingy stings. Just putting some more flowers in there. Thank you very much. All right, that worked out. All right, so let's wrap this up by going to get some fishies! Some fishies down in there, and that's actually what our sea snake primarily. Oop, chicken? No chicken. What our sea snake primarily eats is the fish, which I find personally to be extremely fascinating. Tate, sit. You can help me. I know we're at the fishing spot. I know it's your most excited spot ever. There's Ame just swimming along the back, so don't worry. We still have our albino dolphin. That's going to be one of the projects that I tidy. Oh, dang it! That I tidy up on. In a little bit, get this tidied up so that Ame has like a nice little area to exist in. All right, I see a really cool clownfish. No, Dr. Nami, you may not leave. I'm sorry. All right, let's build a couple more. Let's see, here's some shark teeth. Here's my shark net. Do I have any more string? I have to have string somewhere. I had a giant pile of it. Surely I didn't lose my giant pile of string. There we go. I knew I had it laying around somewhere. Let's see. And if I remember correctly, man, that was actually pretty seren. Oops, why'd I do that? Serendipitous to run into a shark, I suppose. I just hope that they don't make a regular habit. There we go. Look at all these nets we've got now. Let's go catch all sorts of fish. I just really hope they don't make a regular habit of trying. No, Dr. Nami. I'll make you a bedroom soon, okay? I'll give you a little bedroom. Right now, you at least have a bed. Usually, it's my bed, but you can borrow it. Let's see, we'll put the sponges in here, put those in here. Let's see, put some of these water buckets away. That salmon has gotten so big! Alright, now let's come down here because I see a cutie patootie! And you're mine! Come back here, net. Oh, cute little guy. I think he's a little clownfish. I definitely want a clownfish. Is that a piranha? I don't want a piranha. There's another clownfish! Ame, don't eat it! Oh, I got it! Sweet! Oh man, it's really fun. Like, you have to chase them down and toss the net on top of them. A jellyfish! Can we catch the jellyfish with the net? Hey, no stinging. No stinging. Oop, oop, hey, what did I say? No stinging. Meanie? I thought you caught a jellyfish with the fish net, but I must be wrong. Well, that's okay. I'll consider jellyfish catching in just a second. Maybe if I try again. Eh? There's lots of them in here. Eh? Ah, no! Jeez, you guys. I'll figure out how to catch you. Next thing you know, you'll be in one of my aquariums. Jellyfish are actually very pretty, in my opinion. Okay. There's another one! Little fish! You're mine, little fish! Come here. There you are. Come here. Come here. You're gonna go in my sea snake exhibit. Which may not work out well for you because you are the primary diet, small fish and at times small octopi, apparently. Though I would love to know who reported that for their diet. Because, I mean, how's a sea snake gonna eat an octopus? I guess they're a small octopus, like itty bitty ones. But still, it just sounds so weird. Oh! Oh no, Tate! I didn't mean to accidentally give you our little, I believe this is a bluegill, so we're just gonna name it Blue. But I didn't mean to accidentally. Come here, Blue! Back in the net! Whoops. All right, come, Lily. Freaking not paying attention to what I'm doing there. All right, oh, Lily, Tate, it's lunch. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Come here, guys, lunch. Fresh pork. There we go. You guys can eat the zoo residents, okay? No eating of the zoo residents. That's some like golden rule. All right, let's hop over here. But yes, the primary diet of our little sea snakes is actually small fish and apparently, as I said, octopi. Let's pop over here. There he goes. Look at him go. Look at him go. I'm so proud of him. Good job. Good job, little coral snake. All right, and let's toss our fishies in here. Okay, where's my do-do-do-do-do-do limestone? Almost there. There we go. All right, so hi, little guy. All right, in you go. There we are. See, and some fish spawn in too, so that'll be kind of interesting. Go on, you can go swimming. Go on, shoo. Get down there. That's right. Move it. There we go. No! Crap. We might have to change the type of window we have here, 'cause he got sucked down into that hole. Well, let's keep an eye on our fish. Put you over here. I hope you can swim deeper than that. Lily, you didn't. Tate, Lily. You guys. Ugh. Lily, where are you? Lily, you scared me. I thought you jumped, like, teleported in somewhere. Tate, sit. You dogs need to behave yourselves. Tate, stay there. Good. Jeez, that scared me. I thought Lily like teleported in under the fish tank where the meteorite is. I'm like, oh no, there's monsters down there, Lily. Don't do it. Oh, there he goes. He's swimming now. Just needed a minute of encouragement. All right, so then we've got two little clownfish. We're just gonna name them like Orange Clown. There you go, little one. Off you are. And then, can I name you Orange Clown too? I sure can. Whoop! No! 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 Okay, come here. Oh, we're We're gonna have to be very careful about that. All right, let's keep an eye on our fish. If I see one more fish accidentally slip in there, but I think it'll be okay because, let's see, there's that fish. Yeah, I think it'll be okay. But we'll keep an eye on them. We don't want to lose our fish. And there goes our snake swimming around in the water. Not bothered for the world. Wow. This is so exciting. All right, let's see. Come down here. Kind of tidy this up. Look at them. Look at all of them. Kind of moving around, moving and grooving, figuring out what to do. What an interesting little thing. Let's go catch more fish. We've got enough time. Let's go catch another batch of fish. And then I think that we can call at least the interior of that exhibit done. At least till we get glowstone to properly heat and maintain the exhibit, which is one of my goals. All right, let's see. Any more little fish? There's a jellyfish again. Mean old jellyfish. Oh, hey, there's one of you. Can I catch you? Ow. Ow. Fine. I'll take that as my answer. Jerks. Stingrays. All right, let's come over here. Hey, Ame. Oh, hey, Ame. That's one of the little fishies. I don't think I can catch it with a net. I think it takes a bowl. Oh, hey, I caught it with a net. Sweet. Thank you, Ame. Oh, there's another one of the little fishies. Diversity. Oh, fun. Any more? This is really fun. And it's fun knowing we can all add it to the tank. One day we'll have... Ooh, okay. Oh, whoop. There's some dead fish in here. You don't want to join them, my friend. Come with me instead. There we go. Another clownfish. And that should top it off. I'm pretty excited. Our coral snake exhibit is almost done. I'm trying to think of any more fun facts. Oh yeah, you guys might be wondering where sea snakes kind of are. If you're in Australia, you're probably definitely familiar with them. You guys have like 33 different species of the 62. Mostly in the Pacific Ocean. If you are where I am, over by the Atlantic Ocean, there are no sea snakes. Oops. There are no sea snakes. The water is too cold. Too cold. So they've never really moseyed over to this part. Let's see. I'm going to throw you in. I think you're just little fish. So we're just going to call you little fish. There you go, little fish one. Another little fish. Your fish. I'm not really going to give you guys individual names. And then clownfish. In you guys go. Big happy fish family. Hopefully. All right. Man, I love having a magnetic pick sometimes. It's just awesome. How are all the fish doing? I see lots of fish there. I see lots of fish here. I see a happy snake. Lillian Tate, come on. Let's go take a quick nap. And then we'll check on the fish to get one good look at them. But if you're over where I am, Atlantic Ocean, they're not really over here. The cold water at the tip of South Africa kind of discourages the snakes from moving from the Indian Ocean and the Pacific over to, under Africa over to the Atlantic Ocean. So the species has never really migrated to that particular ocean. They like warm water as they are still reptiles. Let's see, what else? Oh, yeah. And their nose excretes salts because of the diet of small fish. They have a very high... Look at how cool this looks. Wow. Look at all the little fish. Look at all of them swim around with our snake. That is just so awesome. I can't wait for our like future aquariums now. Stop derping into the box. Don't die. I can't wait for our aquariums now. It's going to be awesome. Oh man. Congratulations, snake. Let's go ahead and maybe get a picture. I should have done that. Oh well, it was dark. Wouldn't have been able to. Look at our snake. Look at our snake go and be a snake. A snake of the water. Look at you. What do you think, my friend? Here, go this way. Go this way. Dang it, Lily! Lily! Also, why is it so dark? That was interesting. I knew it was going to be Lily, too. Wouldn't be you, Tate, even though you love the water. Lily, come. Tate, sit. Lily, no, you don't ignore me. You sit and be a good girl. Oh, silly goose dog, trying to get stuff done here. One final review. Boink, boink. Yep, there's fishy fish being a fish. There's fish being a fish. There's our snake being a good watery sort of snake. Hey, what you doing? What you doing, buddy? Can I get up on this sponge and kind of look at you? Oh yeah, look at all these fishies. We'll keep adding some more. Maybe every time we might start carrying a fishnet, and if we come across like a fun fish, then oops, sorry, buddy. I don't mean to be pushing you around. Sorry about that. And every time we come across a fun one, we can just catch it and like come over here and toss it in. Because I'm not sure if those fish will like survive coming up along here. So far, they seem to be somewhat intelligent and figuring out how not to die. And there we have it. Oh, that's just so awesome. So there's lots of work to do. I'm actually going to be making the next two spots for the exhibit and kind of outlining the rest of the snake house so that it's no longer just a bunch of random exhibits here. That's going to be a project I'm going to be working on before the next episode so that you guys will, well, before the next episode where we come over here. But the next two projects we're going to take on, because I want to finish the snake exhibit so we can move on to other things finally. But the next thing is going to be putting a king cobra, perhaps, question mark, basically a cobra that goes on sand. So I need to do some research to make sure I match up the right species. We're going to put that one there, actually. And this one, I'm not sure what we're going to put here yet. Let's go look at what our options are on snake eggs. I might just look up some fun species. There's that chicken again. That chicken that likes trees and being up high. That is one cool chicken. I like that chicken. Whoops. Well, that's not going to help me. There we go. Here we go. So orange snake, coral snake, which we just used, spotted snake, rattlesnake, dark snake, green snake, cobra snake, python snake. So I'll look up what I think is going to be a fun species to add for our sixth spot. And then, of course, we're going to put in our croc exhibit. And someone mentioned that we should build some bridges. And I didn't expect the croc exhibit to end up being so long. So I agree with you. Bridges, probably two bridges would be some good things to add so that people can walk across and be like, woo, crocodiles, wow. Make a nice big crocodile exhibit. So that should be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to that. Looking forward to getting it all organized. Looking forward to getting back to building a freaking zoo. Whew. So the next episode is going to be a special one because it is going to be our 50th episode. So I'm going to do something that I'm really looking forward to. I just want to make sure I do it in the right spot and in the right way. Because if this works the way I think it is, it's a little bit of a game changer for me. It's something that's going to make me so extremely, exceptionally happy. And so I'm really looking forward to seeing if it works or not. But what is it? Well, you're going to have to wait. You're going to have to wait to find out for the next episode because it's going to be our special episode, which, by the way, means thank you guys so much for watching and for joining in and for learning about sea snakes. I think we covered all the fun stuff. They excrete salt out of their nose. They have one long lung. He's hanging up there. Yeah, he's hiding up there right now. Are you up there, buddy? Might have to build a like little platform so people can find you. I hear him. Where'd he go? No! We didn't just lose our sea snake right at the last second, did we? Oh, no, there he is. You little jerk. Nobody can see you there. Come on. Shoo. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Go over there. That's better. Now I know you're there and you're not going to give me a heart attack. There we go. But that's actually good in terms of building habitats for animals, that they have an area they can hide in. So when they need to feel like they have privacy, not in the way that a human feels like they need privacy, but just in a way where they aren't feeling like a potential predator could be examining them, then, you know, that's it. That's his little hideout spot, but I just wanted to make sure he's still alive, which is a good thing. So yes, he mimics the sea crate, eater of small fish, potentially octopi, though I'm not sure how I feel about that. Oh, look, there he goes. He's off to his little spot again. Silly little fish. Silly little snake. Yeah, they mostly exist in the warmer waters. They like little estuaries. Some lay eggs on land. Most give birth in the sea and stay in the sea. They're actually not as aggressive as people say they are. So if you see one, you don't have to freak out too badly, but they are highly venomous, so you don't want to get bitten. They don't tend to inject you with a lot of venom if you do get bitten, and there are anti-venoms. But still, snakes are amazing. Snakes are awesome. Snakes, most species, are not as aggressive as people say. And basically, just respect them and give them their space, and then you probably won't get bitten. And then you can just enjoy how awesome they are, the amazing part of the ecosystems that we've got going here. All right, everybody. Woo! Finally! Well, I'm gonna get these paths built and get ready for our 50th episode, and I will see you guys then. Bye-bye.